you mean we're lucky to be white?
It's not luck, it's privilege.
And it indeed is my privilege to welcome you all back to the fourth installment of Tumblrisms, as we venture once more into that far-off wilderness, that land of a thousand hug boxes. Today we're going to be looking at a very interesting concept. White privilege is the Tumblrism that we'll be looking at. Now let me preface this video ahead of time by talking directly to the Caucasians in the audience. You might want to just turn this video off, white devil. I don't think you can handle the truth that's coming your way. Now, myself, as a white man, to prepare for this sacrosanct minority sanctuary that we'll be taking a look at, I needed to purify myself and get rid of the inherent evilness of my whiteness. So I stood in front of a mirror and flogged myself while repeating the mantra that I am, of course, responsible for all the poverty in the world and all the illness and war. Every rape is, of course, my fault. Any persecution which happens, regardless of who it's between, is, of course, my fault, because I am white, and being white is not only horrible, but it's a privilege. So we're going to learn more about that. Let's jump in, okay? Let's take a look at white privilege. And it seems that serendipity once again is smiling down upon us as we've found the perfect tumbler for this. Now, it is one among many. Many tumblers talk about white privilege, but this one, it suits our needs pretty well. And that, of course, is thisiswhiteprivilege.tumblr.com. And just looking at this main page, you see that it is a host to many things I like in a tumbler. I love when they have an FAQ section because, God knows, I want to know how to check that privilege. And an FAQ section is a good place to start. It also introduces us to the mods and admins of the site. And I kind of like to know who runs the show. I like to know a little bit about the people behind the scenes. I want to pull back that curtain and get a look at the wizard, if you know what I mean. And right off the bat, it's got a nice little blurb for us before we even get to anything else. White privilege is hard for white people to see, so consider this a compilation album of white privilege's greatest hits. Submit your example. All flavors of people welcome, but we don't serve vanilla at this yogurt shop. Modded by A Naked Sushi, Several Chains, and admin by Dion the Socialist. This website proudly sits at the Black Kids table. While I have good feelings about this, there is no better way to learn about white privilege than from a socialist and a weeaboo. Now sadly, as you can see, Several Chains and A Naked Sushi don't really have a lot of information on their Tumblr. Neither really have a biographical area to look at. They don't really talk about themselves. There are a few postings here or there on Several Chains, or, you know, a few reblogs, and A Naked Sushi, or a Chauvinist Sushi when you get to the actual Tumblr itself, has a few links to articles, but again, it's pretty sparse. There's not a lot of background details. Now, Dion the Socialist, on the other hand, does seem to have a little bit more information on his. But it's a very tiny blurb. You can see it in the upper right-hand corner there. I am the best blogger on the internet. My hashtag NaNoRayMo project is called Asleep at the Controls, and it is a defense of our generation and a love letter to technology that shapes it. Read excerpts from it under my hashtag NaNoRayMo tag. And then, as you can see, he uses his Tumblr, obviously. He reblogs a few things and posts from Facebook and his Twitter account, making sure to, of course, blur out his name. But again, there's not a lot of stuff here. This is kind of disappointing. Usually I'm accustomed to kind of finding out who runs this, but these three people don't really share a lot. Now, the interesting thing is this links, or it says it's associated with, the Black Kids Table, which was a website. Now, when I went to take a look for the website itself, there was nothing there. So I'm not sure if that means that the website is now closed, or if they, you know, lapsed on payments for it and so it got taken back, but it really is just talking about selling domains. And I don't think that's probably what it originally was for. Luckily, you can find a little bit of the history on it on their Facebook page. That's still up, and it does link to a few of the older stories that I think were hosted on the website itself, but again, there's not a ton of stuff. It seems to be kind of abandoned, or not used as much anymore, I guess. So sadly, we don't really have a feeling for who's running it, but you know what, that's okay. We can go look at the FAQs, because that's going to help us. Let's get a feeling for what this Tumblr's about. What exactly is the point of this blog? To compile 1 bajillion examples of white privilege. You're making racism worse by acknowledging race, you know. We're all a part of the human race. Race is a social construct. It is often used as a motivation for murder, genocide, war, and other terrible things. Those things happen because this country has been avoiding having a serious discussion on race. Let's all sit down, be adults, and stop pretending there isn't a problem. I'm white, and I love this blog, but the language you use seems so hostile and alienating. Why do you do that? Part of white privilege is that society is crafted to appeal to you. This blog, however, is a POC space. one that welcomes white people but does not craft its message specifically for white people. Therefore, you will naturally feel as if you were in a hostile environment. You will naturally feel alien. That's a part of being an ally. Confronting your white privilege, a gift you receive from white supremacy through the deaths of millions of people of color throughout the years, should make you feel pretty damn shitty. If you feel bad, it just means you're taking the first important step. Okay, so we have kind of a general idea of what we're dealing with here. This isn't specifically crafted for white people per se, but more a place for POC or people of color to bitch about white people. And if you look a little further down the FAQ, you'll see this, and it says, how can white people fight the white supremacy? And it links you to two different things. So let's pop over and just take a glance at what that is. Now, that leads us over to another Tumblr. I don't know if that's associated. Earlier it said that this was run by four black people with attitudes and a way with words. And if you noticed at the beginning, we only saw three people, and this is a fourth. Maybe this is the fourth person they were talking about. So it's a blog post or an essay, really however you want to look at it. But let's take a look at a little bit of it and kind of see what they're talking about. Fourth, I need media, Hollywood, whoever, to realize that people of color can have complicated roles, dark skin, natural hair, and are human beings. Like Game of Thrones, obviously this story will contain more European/white characters, has two African descent persons, and he's a pirate with less than 100 words combined, if that. I'm tired of all these stories, movies, books, making me feel like white people are the only people who ever had adventures, were heroes, have conflicts, and doubt their abilities even if they are excellent people. I'm tired of race being a way to reel in viewers with controversy instead of because it makes the sense that people of color should be involved in everything white people are involved in. Shows like NBC's Scandal need more light, but I shouldn't have to be excited because 5 of the 14 characters are people of color. The point is, we have a rich history of stories to be told. They can be just as good as Harry Potter, Game of Thrones, Dexter, and BBC's Sherlock or Supernatural. Well, what a fantastic appeal that is to all those different creators of various forms of media and entertainment, be they authors or screenwriters, whether they're stationed in Hollywood or New York. Why, it doesn't show the least bit of egotism or narcissism or hubris to think that you should demand that somebody craft a story specifically for you, or just characters they created and spent years crafting, just because they don't appeal to you specifically. Now sure, somebody might be flippant and say, well hell, if it bothers you that much, go write your own story, go make your own game, go produce your own television show or movie. But that would require work, and work is hard. No, it's much easier to bitch at authors and bitch at creators and tell them, I want you to make it my way, or I'm going to stomp my feet and shake my fist in the air. Kind of like this particular person.
To J.K. Rowling!
Yes, that is exactly as dumb as it sounds. And the funny thing is, Rachel and her Def Jam poetry will be forgotten in 20 years, whereas J.K. Rowling won't be. Fifth, white people realizing money is a part of privilege in a very real way. Let's see white people refuse their inheritance and give it to the Dream Organization or Black Youth or other self-development organizations run by people of color. Find the families of your ancestors and pay reparations to children of laborers. Rebuild places like Newark, New Jersey, where race riots are still historically visible, in broken-down/fire-damaged buildings, and not gentrify them like white people are doing now. Go to schools where white people aren't the overwhelming majority in both the classrooms and faculty rooms, and see how different your education turns out. Well, hey now. See, we're learning things. I did not know that the best way to get rid of privilege was by giving black people money. Why, if I knew that, I'd just empty my bank account, and then I'd be guilt-free. It's kind of like confession in church. If you want to get rid of those sins, you got to see the priest. If you want to get rid of that white privilege, go give Jamal $25. Why, I don't see anything nefarious about that at all. Not a thing. Well, I think we have a good idea of what's waiting for us now that we've looked at the FAQ and met the people running the site and read a little bit about their philosophy. Now, just before we get started, I just want to say, this is a really large Tumblr, and it has a ton of posts. I believe 240, 250 pages of them. It's one of the biggest I've seen yet. So for the sake of brevity and my own sanity, the cross-section we're going to be dealing with is about the first 20 or so pages. But believe me, there's a treasure trove of postings to read on this fucking Tumblr. And here's our first posting. It looks like an image macro. White people nutritional facts. Appropriation, 250 grams. Privilege, 250 grams. This doesn't sound very nutritional. Not sure a citizen would want to eat this. Belief in post-racial society. Superiority complex, that's 300 grams. That's pretty large. Culture, 0 grams. That's interesting. Entitlement, gentrification, genocide. Can't forget the genocide. It's part of a balanced meal. Need to use the N-word. N-word, I'm not sure what they're talking about. Maybe it's astronomy related? Neptune? I'm drawing a blank. I'm going to have to come back to that, I think. And we've got another image macro. What would Grandma think? And there's a little post-it note. Something racist, probably, huh? And then posted underneath, my school is talking about internet safety or something? Well, we all know old white people are just horrible racist bastards. I don't think there's a good one out there. It reminds me of this guy, John Woolman. He wrote this little diary, this little journal. It's pretty terrible. I think he kicked puppies and raped nuns, too. White people are oh my god. You know what? I just thought what the N-word might be. I just thought. It reminded me of that Garth Brooks song.
Motherfucker. What's up, nigga? Gangsta rap, nigga. Nigga. Nigga, 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 nigga. I'm 100% nigga. Nigga, 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 nigga. I'm 200% nigga. Nigga, 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 nigga. Why do police hate niggas? Nigga, 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 nigga. They hate us cause our dicks is bigger.
Anonymous asked, racism is racism. Hating people for being white actually does happen, and it doesn't make anything better. In that same way, heterophobia exists too, and I can say I'm actually pretty ashamed that I used to think like that. People are people and should be judged on their actions, wouldn't you agree? The response? Please get back to me about that reverse racism and heterophobia when people start being murdered because they are white cis shits. So, I mean, social justice Wario is pretty great. Now, we have another one in a similar vein. List of white people who've been killed based on stereotypes. And, as you can see, that's the list. The punchline, as it were. There's no list at all because white people aren't murdered for being white. It just doesn't happen. Again, we have a sort of similar one. So few words asked. We don't talk about Irish people on here because that would mean admitting that white is not a gateway to a perfect life, and I mean that would dismantle our entire victim complex. Like, this is why people don't take this blog seriously. But I know how this works. You don't actually want to show me anything or change anything. You just want to play the victim, so that works great for you. Educate yourself. Oh my god, stop oppressing me by asking me to put facts into my beliefs. I mean, come on. I just... slow clap. When did we say white people have a perfect life? Like, a bunch of you come in here, you get scared, you feel attacked, and I understand that. But you guys never try to understand what I'm saying. C.S. Colworth asked, what about white countries that never had colonies? I'm not Googling this shit just because you're lazy and don't have an answer to anything that challenges you. Response? And you're lazy for not looking it up. Damn, son, I ain't your teacher, nor your mom. I'm a fucking stranger who don't owe you shit. White people are really upset today. Whoa, a stranger on the internet won't do what I want them to do. I'm going to insult them and think they're so juvenile that they'll have to do what I want. Brilliant. C.S. Below that, there was another one similar again. Asylvania asked, did Irishmen in England in the 1970s have white privilege? Response, we don't talk about Irish people here. C.S. Official Dick Cheney asked, for someone so opposed to racism, you sure are a fucking racist. Q, you're white, so you don't know anything about racism. Let's see. White privilege is hard for white people to see. How about black crime is hard for black people to see? Oh, got a better one. The enormous amount the country spends on welfare is hard for black people to see. Well, gee, those sound like a racist statements to me. You know, judging on a whole race-based stereotype. Response? Yeah, sucks, doesn't it? Oh, and white people are the number one recipients of welfare, just in case you didn't know. C.S. P.S. Your haircut sucks. Well, I think these are just brilliant points. White people are terrible, but they're also never targeted for being white. I mean, sure, Caesar marched an army to go exterminate the Gauls, but that doesn't count. And Slavic people, you know, the origin of the word slave, that doesn't matter either. You know, who cares about them? You could debate Jews, whether they're white or not, and the official and unofficial numbers regarding the Holocaust, but we don't want to talk about that. Irish people? Not even going to mention them. No, that would be too inconvenient and difficult to talk about. Clearly, white people are never oppressed. Just don't ever go to South Africa and try to run a farm. You'll get raped, beaten, and have your children lit on fire. Again, not going to talk about it because that's uncomfortable. I also like the fact-based analysis of welfare recipients in the U.S. that CS did here. Granted, he didn't mention population sizes, but again, that's inconvenient, just like those Gauls, Slavs, Jews, Irish, and South African farmers. But of course, those are old examples. I mean, the majority don't happen nowadays. White people are impervious to harassment for being white or for being targeted for being white. I don't know where that idea comes from. I think CS is an intelligent individual. I mean, this kid, obviously, was making this up, Aaron Dugmore. What a little liar. You know, the 9-year-old that hung himself because he was bullied for being white. That doesn't happen. And thank God, another Tumblr was around to explain it all to us. As you can see here, this is problematic. Racism is not a thing against white people. Racism is power plus prejudice. What happened to him might have been horrible, it might have been highly prejudiced, but it was not racist. It is not your place as white people to attempt to define what is racist and what isn't. Please spare us your white tears. Well, I'll be sure to tell Aaron Dugmore's mother to try to spare her white tears so it doesn't offend you as her 9-year-old son swings from the rafters, you disgusting fucking pieces of shit. Number 1613. White privilege is having a normal last name. White privilege is not having others snub your family name simply because they can't pronounce it. Your ignorance doesn't make my culture wrong. Well, I agree. And to all the white people out there, remember, the dash be silent, yo. Pelea Princea asked, can you please recommend a way for me to respond when my teachers at my new school continue to make comments about my ethnic hair and name? The response? Take a dump on their desk and say it's part of your exotic culture. Dion. Well, that's a brilliant way to conform to a new classroom environment. Be hostile and don't take the time to try to educate other people about what your name means and why you look different. People interacting with other people like they were normal and trying to bridge cultural differences? That's silly. No, instead, shit all over the classroom floor and get angry at them for not accepting you carte blanche. That is the adult way to handle that situation. Number 1615. White privilege is your white boyfriend continually refusing to acknowledge your race no matter how much you tell him it's important to you. White privilege is your white boyfriend trying to give you a colorblind excuse and say that all he sees is a human being, instead of trying to understand that you are a member of a race and how it affects you. Mod note, why the hell are you still with him? I agree. You should definitely dump the person who loves you and is trying to see you as a human being and not a member of some separate group. Why, that's just ridiculous. No, it's more important that you identify as black and segregate yourself off from anybody who might be different from you. That's not an unreasonable thing to do. So here's a question, because I've seen arguments like the following all over Tumblr, and I just thought maybe I could have this explained to me. If somebody has a fetish for black women, they're called a racist for exoticizing her. If somebody isn't attracted to a black woman, they're called a racist for being exclusive. If somebody is attracted to somebody regardless of their race, they're erasing their identity. So what's the right way to play the game? Response? This isn't a game. Take a step back, realize what you just said. People have a fetish for shoes, for whips, for foods. These are objects. People are not objects. There's a difference between liking someone and objectifying them. I'm offended that you would even suggest they're the same. And don't put fucking quotes on terms you don't like. When someone is attracted to somebody regardless of race, this is not the same as saying they're colorblind, which is saying you don't see race. How fucking hard is it for people to view black women as people? Shit. Love me for me. Being black is part of me, but don't just love me because I'm black. It's not that hard. C.S. Well, Vagrant Constellations, let me answer that question for you. The only way to win this game is not to play at all. I recommend tic-tac-toe. Or dating Asian women. God, Asian women are just perfect. Several whites unfollowed us for a recent post we made about not wanting their voices here. We'd like to thank those white people and invite any other fair-weather white allies to unfollow them out the door. If you can't stand the thought of POC space where your voice is not welcome, you are not our ally. You are much too self-involved for this, and you are wasting your time and ours by pretending to be an ally. Dion. Reminder, white people are free to follow this blog and like reblog from it, as long as their intentions are good, but we really don't want to hear from you no matter what you have to say. We don't care if it's a compliment, a thank you, an apology, or an innocent question. This blog is a space for POC. The moment you enter it, you will be treated with the utmost hostility because we don't want your voice here in any capacity. Dion. Well, Dion, who wouldn't want to be your ally? It sounds like your side is the best side. I love to join a team that disregards my opinion and hates me just for the fact that I exist. That's somebody I want to back. That's somebody I want to march behind. You know, it's strange. This Dion person seems somewhat hostile towards people who come to this particular Tumblr. But again, I don't really know much about him. I just wish I could find out more about who Dion is. Oh, wait a second. What's this? It's a tweet from Tim Weiss. And, well, somebody responding named Dion, and the picture looks just like the other picture from the Facebook posting on his original Tumblr account. Could it really be Dion? I don't know. Let's follow that up. Let me take a look at the Twitter account. I think this might be the individual. Maybe we can learn a little bit more about Dion and see how we can best be his ally. Let's see. Writer, blogger, journalism teacher. That's interesting. What is this? Oh, it says down a little further down the way. I really want to be an admissions counselor. I really think that's the path for me. Traveling and helping kids go to college. And he tweeted that on the 18th of November, 2013. You know, I find that somewhat interesting. That Dion wants to, one, be a teacher in college, and two, be in charge of admissions and who gets to go into college. You know, I remember I used to have this philosophy professor, and he liked to do thought experiments. He said it really helped you try to evaluate something or look at something from every possible angle to really try to get a grasp of it. So let's try a thought experiment. Let's do a little role reversal. Let's say, instead of thisiswhiteprivilege.com, this particular Tumblr was called, I don't know, Jumpin' Jack Jigaboos. You know? And every post on there was about how horrible black people are. How black people are criminals and welfare recipients, how they're violent and they rape and they steal, and how anybody who has a different opinion other than that can't talk, and if a black person tried to come to that particular Tumblr, they'd be told to go away. And then, again, for the sake of argument and following our thought experiment, let's say we found out that the person who ran Jack Jumpin' Jigaboos just happened to be a college professor, a white college professor, and he was in charge of, well, a journalism class and admissions. Now, ask yourself, would that person have a bias that might interfere with their ability to conduct their job in an unbiased way? I don't know. But again, it's not my place to speak as an ally.